And now for our last group, Blue Dream, with Zoe Winger, Emily Nevin, Richard Alberto, and Jessica Fernando.
Saved up and tried her best to make this Christmas normal. And under that guise of normality is the truth of the abandonment, the truth about the empty seats all those Friday and Saturday nights, and the truth about the misplaced guilt I am made to feel every single time he calls. And under those calls is the cry of a desperate man trying his best to hold on to something he just can't grasp anymore. And under those grasping hands are the nicotine-stained lies leading up to yellow eyes. And under those yellow eyes is the brain of a man who can't place his love in the right daughter. And under that second daughter is the confidence bestowed by a father figure she also lacked as a child. Under that child beats the same heart as my own, yet under those beats is the comfort in knowing he won't leave her. He could never leave her. And under that comfort sits my discomfort at the notion that he left us so easily. And under that notion scream the cries of two grown men who revert back to children sitting at the dinner table trying their best to console their mother who never saw it coming. And under the consolation are the stacks of old dishes he purchased for the family. Under that family are the shattered ceramic plates that frantic mother allowed her sons to break in order for them to comprehend that daddy was never coming back. And under those pieces sits the backyard in which we grew up, the backyard where we laughed and played in garden. And under that garden is a man eternally checking it, littering the ground with secret cigarette butts. And under those cigarette butts sits the nervous child pacing back and forth in the living room, biting her fingers bloody because she thinks her father has become a zombie and isn't coming back. And under that fear growls a mother who knew it was better to be rid of him than to let him tear apart our lives. And under that ferocity is the unconscious knowledge that she was never going to let her children live through the drunken fights, broken appliances, and rumbling stomachs, all consequence of a destroyed marriage. And under that marriage grew the most powerful woman I have ever met. And under that woman is a family, four members strong. And under those members is the most unbelievable connection, a flowing current of veins, all howling with the same blood running strong through our hearts.
Judges' scores are 9, 9, 9, 9.5, 9.5, and 9.5.
Hello there. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Richard, and I would like to dedicate this poem to my mother.
Love you, baby!
When I think of my childhood, I see a mother trying to survive. As she wipes off the tears from her eyes, she cries begging for help, but the radical beast won't let her survive. Another tear, another lie, from a cheer to a cry, she feels darkness. I can see the fear in her eyes as she's trying to survive, having no hope she will once again feel alive. He beats her. The torque in his jab, the hook to the stomach, the wound is gushing, my heart is rushing, a young corrupted mind, looking at the ceiling, frightened by the beating, begging for it all to stop before my mind gets beaten. Torture, brutality, all that's kept inside him, and the tears drip, my eyes are dim, and the chances are slim that I will once again see him as my old loving father. The family structure is weakening, the divorce is secure to all that is insecure. Why are we so impure? My soul is scarred, the world is dark. I need a cure, something pure, so I could be sure that my mom would be cured mentally, physically, by the beating she has received by the insecure. What an unbearable pain, it feels so irrelevant. I want to feel benevolent, but you filled my heart with hatred and pain. Is this what you really wanted, Dad? I'm just saying nothing will ever be the same.
Judges' scores are 9, 9, 9, 10, 10, and 10.
As I paint my face with powdered confidence, I anticipate the wild free will of youth longing to be a creature of the night. Hairspray and black leather, I rope myself to the relics of reality, masked from society, blissfully beyond the realms of normality. Beyond the bedroom, the stairs, the lock and key of this confined home, a car smoking from reckless youth waits for me outside. Quick kiss for mom, quick kiss for the kid's sister, but then those naive eyes that see no lies gaze into mine and she speaks. Are you gonna come back? Her innocence reflects the lack of my own, and in an instant, all I want to do is cradle those round cheeks in my cracked hands, hold a tangible source of love so strong it hurts. But I want to be free from the shackles of young morals, flirting with danger, rampaging and engaging in a forbidden love. Music swirls through my mind, grinding time and singing lies with nonviolent crimes. I live this life of the night, but I'm lured by the love of my sister. I love her brightly colored striped tights that hug her skinny chicken legs. I love the waterfall of blonde curls that bounce freely by her waist, caked with syrup or gum or other residue from a day in the life of a five-year-old. But I'm 17, seeing the world through the bottom of a bottle with rules I refuse to follow. And when she asks, are you gonna come back? I'm riddled with guilt from these 42 inches of human life and learned loveliness, lying in my heart of hearts, healing the hellish happiness of my soul. Each night I spend out with less than respectable intentions, and that question seems to rise. I see the worry in her eyes, and the car waiting beyond my front door seems irrelevant. I remember the way selective hearing always seems to get the best of her. The way her tiny arms and legs always frantically flail with excitement. The way she skips and dances instead of simply walking. I want to burrow myself inside her aura of innocence, live inside her soul, allow the young blood that runs through her veins, course through my own to self-medicate, and morph from two entirely different entities into one so she never feels abandoned, knows I'll never really leave. And when she asks, are you going to come back? I say yes, but let the darkness seduce me, enticing blackness that allows my inhibitions to run free, a necessity for a broken soul. The car outside is no longer waiting, and I'm gone. Dirty words drip from my lips like blood, and the burning in my lungs restrain me from spitting the word no. My family is behind me, and the world lies ahead, and for yet another night, I am free. But when the sun comes up, I remember my home is her heart, and I need for my sister to know that I will kiss that crooked smile and hold her sticky little hands, and despite the fading reality beyond the smoky haze of the ever-consuming night, I will always come back.